Hi there. Sorry, on my last video of my deck, my voice I realized was real low, couldn't be heard. I'm new at this. Just wanted to show you my windowsill here. I live in a townhouse, so there is limited space, limited window space, and with three cats who love the windows, there's only certain places they can be put. And this window, it's my western window, and my plants just love it. They love the light. Now, as you can see here, my pilea, it's doing beautiful, absolutely beautiful. Now, on this window, in the wintertime, I put my Christmas cacti, and these somehow get moved to the ledge inside. And in the winter, needless to say, they don't do so well. But right now, they're great. The pilea is doing really good. I've had it for a while. Here is a plant that I don't know what it's called. It's got a little cottage in there because I love that kind of thing. It was struggling a bit. I had it somewhere else. I had it indoors and near the table, and it wasn't getting much light, as you can see. But it's picking up, so we've got high hopes for this one. And right here, we have a coffee plant, which I saw in the store a few days ago. I was super surprised, and it's doing quite well. I'm not going to get any coffee beans out of it, but because this is Canada, where nothing like that grows, I don't think. But we're going to have some good, a beautiful plant. And this one here, I found a few months ago after a long time of searching. This is the string of pearls. I love it. I'm hoping it will grow even bigger and beautifuler, more beautiful. I'm not an expert in plants. I look through YouTube videos and get advice because I do not know what to do. My plant, I don't have a green thumb, I have to tell you. Right here is something that I learned from YouTube, from one of the geniuses of YouTube. How to propagate an African violet. There it is. I can't even hold it up to the camera. That's how bad I am. There, how to propagate an African violet from a leaf cutting. Started this April 13th, and it is now June 27th or June 28th, and that's how big the babies have grown so far. So very soon, we'll be separating them. And thanks to one of the ladies I've subscribed to, Soniti, she suggests putting two plants in one pot, give you a more fuller flowered plant, which I'm going to do that. So thank you, Soniti. Wanted to fix that. And this is an absolutely gorgeous orchid that my sister gave me for my birthday in April. I bought an orchid years ago and it died. This one has not only survived but thrived. When she gave it to me, it was the flowers only, they were bloomed only up to here. And in that 2 months, they bloomed all the way to the very tip. So this was looking so gorgeous. And now they're starting to die out. It's time for them to, and they're doing that. And I've been studying all those tips on YouTube on what to do. And thanks to Soniti, and look what's happened. I've been successful, I guess, because a leaf is coming. So I'm doing something right. So I hope to have good ideas about, I'll show you guys updates about this beautiful plant as well as the violets. And I love fairy gardens. Here are two of my fairy gardens. This one here, maybe I'll open this a little bit, show you I have a little fairy garden. And this one here. Turn around. little patio there, which I made, and all that. So that is that. And I have one more little fairy garden here. The rest I can show you another time. It's miniature shamrocks, which is doing great. Little lake, you can see, with a froggy. And then a little hobbit house. I guess I'm a little weird that way. I do like things that way. But anyway, thanks for visiting. Thanks for watching. Hope to see you again soon.